Oxygen, an atmospheric gas, increases saturation of hemoglobin oxygen, and when used at therapeutic concentrations, could aid the oxygenation of certain tissues as long as the patient's not in shock or has some other complication like carbon monoxide poisoning, which could affect the distribution or reception of oxygen molecules within the body and its cells. So let's look at some of the indications for oxygen therapy. The primary indications for the use of oxygen in PALS is the presence of hypoxemia, which would be representative of an SpO2 less than 94%, severe respiratory depression or distress as in asthma, respiratory distress or depression as in opioid overdose. When administering oxygen therapy after the return of spontaneous circulation, otherwise known as ROSC or ROSC, it's important to deliver sufficient oxygenation to maintain an SpO2 that's greater than or equal to 94%. So what are some of the precautions and contraindications? There are few, if any, known contraindications for oxygen use in the true hypoxic patient. Precautions should be based on new and ongoing research revealing the vasoconstrictive properties that hyperoxia may produce. If we begin to hyperoxygenate a normoxic cardiac patient, some theories and studies are indicating that we could be causing lower oxygen absorption and distribution to vital organs that need oxygenation. So what's the pediatric dosage? The appropriate dose of oxygen is dependent upon the needs of the patient and their unique oxygen requirements. That being said, oxygen is several different methods for delivery, and the percentage of oxygenation is regulated by the flow of oxygen per minute and the delivery adjunct used. If oxygen delivery by nasal cannula is indicated, it would be delivered at a rate of 2 to 6 liters per minute. If a non-rebreather mask is used, the flow rate is increased to 10 to 15 liters per minute. Delivery of oxygenation ventilations would be delivered via a positive pressure device like a bag valve mask. In this case, oxygen flow should be set at 15 liters per minute. It's important that under current guidelines, we are titrating oxygen therapy to maintain an SpO2 of at least 94%. It's also vital to remember that a restricted airway will affect the therapeutic response of oxygenation treatment. Use of a basic or advanced airway adjunct may be needed in order to open or maintain an open and patent airway in order to treat the patient effectively. Remember to monitor the patient's signs and symptoms, not just the monitor. In other words, if the SpO2 reads 92% but the skin appears to be normal, then maybe they have an underlying blood disorder like anemia, which can impede the cyanosis due to a lack of hemoglobin and give an inaccurate appearance of adequate oxygenation.